ForceField Weather Barrier System from Georgia-Pacific consists of engineered wood sheathing panels, an enhanced overlay, and accessories that provide a continuous air and water-resistive barrier. The engineered wood panels and advanced accessories create a smarter sheathing system that resists the effects of moisture and air on structural performance. ForceField Weather Barrier System helps protect your builds during the construction process. Let's take a look at how to properly install this smarter sheathing system. Before starting any construction project, keep safety top of mind. Always remember to wear personal protective equipment, PPE, to protect from any on-site hazards. To get started, you'll need the following tools to complete this installation: a tape measure, cutting tool like a knife, a saw, straight edge, chalk box, J-roller, pneumatic nail gun and airline regulators, an air compressor, and a T-square. For proper storage and to assure optimum performance, ForceField panels must be stored and handled properly. Adhering to the guidelines found in the ForceField installation instructions will help protect panels from damage in storage, during shipment, and on the job site. When cutting the panel, set the saw blade to the proper depth to cut completely through the panel. Take precaution not to cut the panel below if cutting on top of the stack. When installing the panels, the panels may be installed either vertically or horizontally to the framing with the gray side of the ForceField panels facing out. Spacing of 1/8 of an inch between the panels should be maintained at all edges and end joints. Fasten the panels according to project specifications and local building code requirements. General fastening guidelines for wood sheathing are to use a minimum 6D common nail spaced 6 inches off-center along panel edges and 12 inches off-center at intermediate supports. If pneumatic nail guns are used, be sure to set air pressure to drive nail heads flush or a maximum of 1/16 of an inch below the panel surface. Install a backer rod between the ForceField panel and concrete. Remove the backing and center the AT flashing tape over the joint and press firmly into place. Roll over the tape with a J-roller to remove wrinkles and air bubbles. Where splices occur, overlap the tape a minimum 2 inches. For this video, we are going to be using the black ForceField Seam Tape Plus. Our gray ForceField Seam Tape is offered in retail channels and can be used where ForceField Seam Tape Plus is shown. To tape the panel seams, ensure the surface is free from moisture, frost, dust, dirt, and other bond-inhibiting materials. Center the ForceField Seam Tape Plus over the panel seam. Apply firm pressure on the tape surface with your hand to ensure that a continuous bond is achieved between the tape and the panel surface and to eliminate wrinkles and air bubbles. As a best practice, use a J-roller to roll over the tape after hand application. Apply the tape in a shingle lap method so that it overlaps a minimum 2 inches at splices and T-joints. Let's look at how to install corner seal and seam tape plus on inside and outside corners. Cut a manageable length of corner seal and pre-bend shape to form an inside or outside corner. Align the corner seal 1 to 2 inches from the top of the wall and secure along the edges at 3-foot intervals, staying a maximum 1 inch from the outer edge. Starting at the bottom, place a 6-inch piece of ForceField seam tape plus over the corner seal and ForceField panel. Then, center ForceField Seam Tape Plus over one edge of the corner seal so that a minimum of 1 inch overlaps onto the ForceField panel. Repeat process on the other side of the corner. Apply a 6-inch piece of ForceField Seam Tape Plus across the top of the corner seal. Apply firm pressure on the tape surface with your hand to ensure that a continuous bond is achieved between the tape and the panel surface and to eliminate wrinkles and air bubbles. As a best practice, use a J-roller to roll over the tape after hand application. For installing outside corners, follow the same process as inside corner application. Prior to treating material transitions, ensure the surface is free from moisture, frost, dust, dirt, and other bond-inhibiting materials. Where the ForceField panel abuts masonry, provide a minimum of 1/2 inch gap. Use a backer rod to fill the gap between substrates. Remove backing from the AT flashing tape and center over the joint and press firmly into place. Apply the tape in a shingle lap method so that it overlaps a minimum 2 inches at splices and T-joints. Lastly, Apply firm pressure using a J-roller to ensure that a continuous bond is achieved and to eliminate wrinkles and air bubbles. Next, let's take a look at window rough opening treatment using ForceField AT flashing and ForceField Flex flashing. Before the application of the flashing, ensure that the surface is free from moisture, frost, dust, dirt, and other bond-inhibiting materials. Cut appropriate length of ForceField Flex flashing so it extends 6 inches up the jambs. Position the flexed flashing inside the rough opening over the sill, starting at one side. Peel and fold the release liner back and press into place. Starting at the corners, stretch flashing out and onto the face of the panel and up the jamb. Then pull the flashing down onto the face of the panel. Ensure a minimum 2 inches of flashing extends onto the panel surface. Apply firm pressure using a J-roller to ensure that a continuous bond is achieved between the tape and the surface and to eliminate wrinkles and air bubbles. Cut 2 pieces of ForceField AT flashing and position into each head jamb corner. Cut 2 additional pieces of ForceField AT flashing for the jambs, long enough so the tape extends over the ForceField Flex flashing and past the header. Remove the release liner and position the ForceField AT flashing over the ForceField Flex flashing, wrapping into the rough opening and onto the panel surface a minimum 2 inches. Cut a piece of AT flashing for the header long enough that it extends over the jamb flashing. Remove release liner and install so that it shingle laps over the jamb flashing. Roll over all of the flashing tapes with a J-roller, applying firm pressure to ensure that a continuous bond is achieved and to eliminate wrinkles and air bubbles. For flanged windows using AT flashing, install the window per the window manufacturer's instructions. Install ForceField AT flashing over the window flanges on the sides, then the header. It is recommended that the windowsill flange is left open to allow for drainage. For more information on ForceField Weather Barrier System, please visit gpforcefield.com.